do the assistant. Oh. So it would be like me, whoever the community assistant and the usher is, and then you would visit everybody else.
Okay, are you one of the assistants?
Well, I play the piano during the...
But who are two people coming up to?
Gord is going to be the usher. And then if the person who's supposed to be Allison Brent doesn't show up, we have somebody else lined up to
come
the
up and do
it.
And you'll, but I'll bring communion to you.
No, we come down.
You come with those two assistants.
Yes.
That's right. I remember now. Thank you.
All right. I'm going to head
down. Okay, I'll head down. Good morning. Happy New Year's Day, and also the blessing of the name of Jesus be with you. On January 1st in the liturgical calendar, this is the name of Jesus, not only New Year's Day. So welcome to this time of worship together. The altar flowers are in remembrance of Stephanie Krause, whose service of Christian burial was on December 30th. And our prayers and the comfort of our faith are with Terry and his family. Also, our prayers and the comfort of our Christian faith are with the family of Allison Bratton, whose mother, Helen Stuck, passed away yesterday. So we keep Allison and her family in our prayers, giving thanks for the life and faith of Helen. In the prayers today, I've been asked to include aloud Dot Albright and Leslie Bright, Carolyn Caldwell, Catherine Ebling and Charles Ebling, and Brett Thompson. Please keep all who are listed in the prayer concerns in your prayers, and as you give me guidance, I'll include all those names or more of those names in future Sundays. So today I begin as your interim pastor. I am thankful to be with you in this transition that I will share with you, and will continue to pray and serve with you as you go through this time, we go through this time together. Wednesday to Saturday of this week, I'm attending a course on spiritual direction offered by the Lutheran Theological Southern Seminary in Columbia, South Carolina. I'll be doing that by Zoom, so I'll be in the area. But if there's are emergencies, you can reach me, but I'll be in that class. And next Sunday, Reverend Evan Houck will be leading worship. He'll be here on the second Sunday of each month, except in April, when Easter's the second Sunday. And I will be with you three of the four Sundays every month. Okay, so I'll see you on January 15th and 22nd. Are there other announcements? I think those are all the ones I have. Again, good to be with you today and welcome on this new year, new day, the name of Jesus. And so I'll ask you to stand and turn to the order for confession and forgiveness. It's not in your bulletin. Then we have the opening hymn. It's on page 56. So I'll ask you to stand as you are able for a brief order for confession and forgiveness. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. We pause for a moment of prayer and then the words of our confession. Most merciful God, we confess that we are in bondage to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways. To the glory of your holy name, amen. Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for us, and for his sake forgives us all our sins. By the authority of Jesus our Lord, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And as you know, the gathering hymn is number 40. grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all,
and also with you.
Let us pray. Eternal Father, you gave your Son the name of Jesus to be a sign of our salvation. Plant in every heart the love of the Savior of the world, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated.
Good morning. The first lesson comes from the sixth chapter of Numbers. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Speak to Aaron and his sons, saying, 'Thus you shall bless the Israelites. You shall say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace.' So they shall put my name on the Israelites, and I will bless them." Here ends the first reading. The psalm is Psalm 8, and it will be read responsively by verse. O Lord, our Lord, how exalted is your name in all the world.
Out of the mouths of infants and children, your majesty is praised above the heavens.
You have set up a stronghold against your adversaries to quell the enemy and the avenger.
When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and stars you have set in their courses.
What is man that you should be mindful of him? The son of man that you should seek him out?
You have made him a little lower than the angels. You adore him with glory and honor.
You give him mastery over the works of your hands. You put all things under his feet.
All sheep and oxen, even the wild beasts of the field.
The birds of the air, the fish of the sea, and whatsoever walks in the paths of the sea.
O Lord, our Lord, how exalted is your name in all the world.
The second reading comes from the fourth chapter of Galatians. When the fullness of time had come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, in order to redeem those who were under the law, so that we might receive adoption as children. And because you are children, God has sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying, "Abba, Father." So you are no longer a slave, but a child. And if a child, then also an heir through God. Here ends the second reading.
The Holy Gospel, according to St. Luke, the second chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. When the angels had left him and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told to them. After 8 days had passed, it was time to circumcise the child. And he was called Jesus, the name given by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Please be seated if there are children that want to come down here. Okay. Would you like to come down or? Okay. I know it's challenging when you're in the middle, you're kind of growing up, and I understand. Thank you. I'll sit right over here then, okay? So you've heard already, I've said it two times, I'll probably say it two more times. It is New Year's Day, so a new year. When do you go back to school?
January
3rd. And your name is?
Charlie.
Charlie? Aubrey. Aubrey, okay. So the name of Jesus. We know how important names are, aren't they? If they call on you in class, they probably call you by name. When we know the name of someone, we can address them. And when we know their name, we can think about them and pray for them, and we become friends. So that is, knowing a name is important. And we know God's name. We know God as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, God as Creator, Savior, Advocate. And today is about the name of Jesus. So the name of Jesus means He saves, Jesus saves. But I'm going to give you a little bookmark that I'm going to use this year. I think it's useful. You might have seen these before, but there are so many names for Jesus in the Bible. It's amazing. And this bookmark has most of, I think all of them drawn from the Bible. You could add one more on the back. Jesus also called himself the living water. Woman at the well, he said, I'll give you this living water, Jesus. Anyway, but when you take this, Jesus at the top, and the definition of the name Jesus is here, Savior of the world. The congregation's name is here, Jesus the Good Shepherd. So I want to give you the bookmark as a reminder of all the names, of all the names of Jesus. We'll have time in children's sermons to talk about those, but just take a look at them and remember them as we begin this new year. Amen. The blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with Charlie and Aubrey. Amen. Thanks for coming up. Still want to get a lectern. We have one at home, and I'll bring it on a day like this. Especially, I'm a little far away from you, but I hope you can hear clearly, and we're not separated by distance. We're close. Let us pray. Almighty God, may the words that are spoken and how we listen be guided by the Holy Spirit and truth of the Holy Gospel, that as we bear the name of Christ, we may carry his name, his love, and his grace to everyone that we meet. In our Lord's name we pray. Amen. So today, on this January 1st, 2023, the name of Jesus, New Year's Day, our relationship as minister and congregational family, as interim pastor, officially begins. But in reality, our relationship is been a little bit longer than just you meeting me today. In reality, our relationship began on October 2nd when I presided at Holy Communion and Libby preached the sermon. Then I led worship with you on October 9th, November 6th, November 20th, and worshiped with you on December 18th, the fourth Sunday in Advent, when this place was very full, because the children and the youth led that worship service, and they did such an excellent job under your guidance and your invitation to have the youth and children lead worship. On December 14th, I was asked to visit Stephanie Krause at Hershey Medical Center. It was a gift for me to be able to visit her, to meet her, to meet Terry and their sons Matt and Tim. And perhaps the biggest gift of that day was to share Holy Communion with Stephanie on the 14th, and she passed away on the 16th, 2 days later. On December 30th, just last Friday, I officiated at Stephanie's interment in your columbarium and her funeral service here in this sanctuary. So we are not really strangers. I may not know all your names yet, and you may not know my name, but we are surely not strangers. Because I've seen your love for Stephanie and your care for Terry, Tim, and Matt and their family. You have offered and will offer care and love and support for Terry and his family in the future. I've seen your faith in God and your love for Christ our Lord, the Good Shepherd, and your listening to the Holy Spirit. I've heard your excellent music program, both by the musicians who share this ministry and those who are singing so well. I've seen your care and love for each other. You have gift of children here, and thanks again for coming up for that children's sermon. Children that you care for and teach and share leadership of worship with them. That's important. Children aren't the future of the church. Children are the church now with you, with us all. So entrusting worship to them is a wonderful gift. I've seen your commitment to the Lower Susquehanna Synod because some of your members, a member, served on Synod Council with me and I met her. Your commitment to the ELCA, to the churches in the area, to the Perry Conference, and your outreach ministry into the community and care for your neighbors. From my view, you are a vital, alive, healthy, strong congregation with deep faith in God, and you are in a transition that you did not expect. But then again, transitions, do we ever expect them? Sometimes we like to plan for them, and sometimes they surprise us. Transitions are nothing to be afraid of or fearful of. Transitions are part of the gift of living in this good garden. So I give thanks for the opportunity to join you as your interim pastor in this transition. I look forward to working with you. Please feel free to call me or to see me in the office to let me know the needs that you have and who should be visited. I will follow up with that. Please tell me the truth of what you are feeling or facing. And if I'm missing something or if I'm not fulfilling your expectations, please tell me before you actually tell anyone else. I would like to know first if there's something I'm missing, and I'd like to hear it from you. And that may indeed happen. We want to keep this communication, our conversations, truthful and loving, caring and open. And I will speak the truth to you. And I will be your pastor as you give me the opportunity. As this has unfolded, I believe the Holy Spirit has brought us together. Visiting Stephanie that day and then having her funeral service before I was even the interim here could have been nothing other than the work of the Holy Spirit. I give thanks that we will be sharing this ministry and that we are in God's hands in all that is to come. On the liturgical calendar, one more time, this is the name of Jesus. How good it is to begin a new year in the name of Jesus. You begin each day in the name of Jesus. We get up and say the Apostles' Creed or the Lord's Prayer. We begin the name in the day in the name of Jesus. How good it is to begin the new year together and to begin the new year sharing Holy Communion, Christ's risen presence. No symbol, the risen Lord present in our midst. The children's sermon focused on the name of Jesus, but also the other holy names or titles that define who Jesus is. What Jesus has done, what Jesus is doing, what Jesus will do yet in the future. Just a week after Christmas, there are some names that are related to Advent, Christmas, and Epiphany that I want to focus on for a minute. The name Jesus means the Lord saves. But Jesus is also called the Messiah, the anointed one, the chosen. Jesus is also Emmanuel, which means God with us. God is with us. In moments of transition, in moments of challenge, in new years, in new days and months, in the face of new people, God is with us. Although Jesus bears the heavenly identity as child of the Holy Spirit, Son of God, and fulfillment of the prophetic visions, Jesus is also called the illegitimate offspring of a young maiden who brought shame to her betrothed, to her father and family. The punishment, according to Deuteronomy, would be severe. But Joseph's character is revealed in Matthew 1, 18 to 21. Joseph, being a righteous man, unwilling to expose Mary to public disgrace, planned to dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." Joseph did as the angel commanded him. He took Mary as his wife, but he had no marital relations with her until the son was born, and he named him Jesus. In the 21st verse of Luke chapter 2, our gospel lesson, at Jesus' circumcision on the eighth day, he is named, and he is placed in the male Jewish covenant by the act of circumcision. Who is Jesus? Jesus is King of Kings, but he will be crucified because Herod, the king of the Jews, brings charges against Jesus. The King of Kings crucified by a puppet king of Rome. Jesus is teacher and Lord, but he will also be denounced by the scribes and Pharisees, who are the interpreters and the teachers of the Holy Scripture. Jesus is Savior, but he will also be taunted on the cross that he can't even save himself. So who is Jesus? We have that beautiful hymn that we began the worship with. What child is this? Can a child save us? And who is he? Good Christians fear for sinners here, the silent word is pleading. Nails, spears shall pierce him through. The cross he bore for me, for you. Hail, hail the word made flesh, the babe, the son of Mary. Verse 2. This tells us it's not so much about Jesus' identity. It's more about our ability to recognize Jesus in our midst. Thanks be to God that Joseph did recognize Jesus as the one who saves us all and broke the law of Leviticus to follow the message from the angel. Since Jesus really is the one who saves, then we have reason to hope that we ourselves will be rescued from the sins we've inflicted on perhaps ourselves or even others, or on the garden. And those words of confession and absolution occurred again today. He is the one who saves. And this meal, Holy Eucharist, for the forgiveness of our sins, receiving the risen Christ. He saves us. Since Jesus really is the Son of the Most High, then we have reason to know that the corruption in our political or economic or social systems doesn't stand a chance to survive or overrule God's love for the world, for all people, and God's justice will overthrow self-serving systems that hurt and marginalize people and destroy the garden. Since Jesus really is God with us, then we have reason to trust that we are not alone and we are not forgotten. No matter how alone we might feel, we are not alone, not forgotten. And also those suffering in the Ukraine are not forgotten. Those suffering in Iran and Myanmar, or any suffering from unjust, self-serving governments, those people are not alone. They are not forgotten by God. And that is a profoundly powerful truth. The hungry, the poor, those who suffer racial prejudice and any judgment against them, anyone, because of who they are or what they look like or who they love, they are not alone nor forgotten by Almighty God. As we recognize and serve Jesus, and maybe in a new year we can recognize more clearly how clearly Jesus is with us, can we remember the words of the blessing that Emily read in the lesson from Numbers? The blessing of God on God's people, on God's earth, on God's creatures. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Let us hold those words close as we bless all others. Let our faces shine on each other and on all people. And let us live, give, and share peace with all. In Jesus' name, amen. The blessing of Almighty God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with each of you. Amen. Thank you. I'll ask you to stand, and you are. We affirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son is worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With wonder and thanksgiving for Christ coming into the world, we pray for the church, the life of the earth, and the whole human family. Holy God, you have given the church the holy name of Jesus, and in him we are your beloved children. Unite us in mission through the power of his Spirit. Make us worthy of the name we bear, the name in which we pray. God of grace, hear our prayer. Renewing God, restore your glory to the earth. Awaken humanity to our kinship with all living things that depend on your provision. Teach us to care for the earth and safeguard its treasures for those who come after us. God of grace, hear our prayer. Peacemaking God, reconcile the nations. Lead those in conflict into negotiation. We pray especially for peace in the Ukraine, and that many may begin to work for that peace, for those in Myanmar and Iran and other places where there is strife. End acts of aggression and violence carried out even in your name. God of grace, hear our prayer. Delivering God, rescue our siblings in any danger, especially communities like much of this nation, and especially Buffalo, New York, suffering extreme weather. Move those in authority to respond with speed and compassion. We pray for the safety of first responders, healthcare workers, police, fire personnel, and all who protect us. God of grace, hear our prayer. Healing God, raise up any who are bowed down with illness or sorrow. Deepen our care and concern for one another. We lift up all who are undergoing transition in relationships, occupations, living situations, or health. Praying especially today for Catherine Ebling, Charles Ebling, and Brent Thompson. For Dot Albright, for Leslie Bright and Carolyn Caldwell. And for those that we name together in this moment of silence. God of grace, hear our prayer. We rejoice with Libby Baker Weichselt, who is beginning her internship at St. James Lutheran in Gettysburg with Pastor Andrew Guy. Bless them in that time together. For Sherry Matter and David Stewart celebrating birthdays this week. God of grace, hear our prayer. Bless and be with the members of Good Shepherd Lutheran Church, Liverpool, as we begin this ministry together as congregation, family, and interim pastor. Strengthen and guide us that we may, and help us to recognize you in our midst and listen closely to the call of the Holy Spirit. God of grace, hear our prayer. Saving God, redeem us and grant us eternal peace. We give thanks for the faithful departed who now rest in your undying love made known in Jesus our Lord. Remembering today Stephanie Kraus, Helen Stock, who surround us in the cloud of witnesses, and praying again for Terry and his family. God of grace, hear our prayer. Pondering the mystery of eternal love made flesh in Jesus, we commend all for whom we pray to the mercy of Almighty God. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always, and also with you. The peace of our Lord be with you. And you may be seated. God of abundance, you have set before us a plentiful harvest. As we feast on your goodness, strengthen us to labor in your field and equip us to bear fruit for the good of all. In the name of Jesus, amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give him thanks and praise. It is indeed right, our duty and joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, almighty and merciful God, through our Savior, Jesus Christ. In the wonder and mystery of the Word made flesh, you have opened the eyes of faith to a new and radiant vision of your glory, that beholding the God made visible, we may be drawn to love the God whom we cannot see. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, Lord God, power and light. Blessed are you, Lord of heaven and earth. In mercy for our fallen world, you gave your only Son, that all those who believe in him should not perish but have eternal life. We give thanks to you for the salvation you have prepared for us through Jesus Christ. Send now your Holy Spirit into our hearts and upon this meal, that we may receive our Lord with a living faith as he comes to us in his Holy Supper. Amen. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Amen. Amen. Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Amen. Amen. Holy God, receive our prayers and praise, as Jesus receives the cries of the needy, and fill us with your blessing, until, needy no longer, and bound to you in love, we feast forever in the triumph of the Lamb, through whom all glory and honor is yours. Almighty God, Creator, Savior, Advocate, now and forever. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Come to the banquet, for now all is ready. Thanks be to God. This is the body of Christ given for you. This is the body of Christ given for you. This is the body of Christ given for you. This is the blood of Christ shed for you. This is the blood of Christ shed for you. This is the blood of Christ shed for you. Amen. Go in peace, and may our Lord's peace remain with you. Amen.
Thank you.
I'll ask you to stand for the prayer after communion. The body of our Lord Jesus and his precious blood strengthen and keep you in true faith to everlasting life. Let us pray. Life-giving God, through this meal you have bandaged our wounds and fed us with your mercy. Now send us forth to live for others, both friend and stranger, that all may come to know your love. This we pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. Go out into the world in peace. Have courage. Hold on to what is good. Return no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the suffering. Honor all persons. Honor all creation. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. And may the love of God and the power and communion of God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you always. Go in peace. Amen. Serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen.